Médecins Sans Frontières was born from the breaking of a silence. In 1971, when the Biafran spoke out about what they had witnessed in Nigeria, témoignage formed one of the core principles of Médecins Sans Frontières' medical action, alongside humanity, independence and impartiality.
The speaking out case studies are a series of reviews, you know, basically using a very rigorous methodology to capture a moment in MSF's history.
Going through MSF history, you know, case by case, going in detail to show what was the debate going on within the movement, within the section, between the field and the headquarters at the very moment that choice had to be made.
The case studies include watershed moments such as Ethiopia, Rwanda and Chechnya.
L'organisation humanitaire Médecins Sans Frontières est priée de quitter l'Éthiopie. Une polémique s'était rapidement engagée entre l'organisation et le gouvernement.
And so it was decided to go on a sort of chronological presentation, going from, you know, each day after each day and crossing information, crossing documentation to make sure that we were as close as possible to what was really happening and not to what was said later on.
Pour la première fois ce matin à Paris, l'organisation humanitaire Médecins Sans Frontières demande carrément une intervention armée.
Il est logique d'appeler à ce qu'il y ait une force armée qui agisse là pour arrêter le massacre, parce que l'humanitaire ne peut rien faire dans ce domaine.
It's essential that we capture, you know, what were the choices that we were faced with, what were the outcomes from making those choices to speak out and under very, very difficult circumstances, and what inherently then can we learn from the choices that we made in those kinds of projects in those moments in history that may be very, very valuable learning points for us.
I appeal here today to His Excellency, the Ambassador of Russia, and through him to President Yeltsin, to stop the bombing of defenseless civilians in Chechnya.
Initially, the speaking out case studies were available only to the movement, but with growing interest from the public and academics and humanitarian workers outside of MSF, the introductions and timelines were posted online.
So there's a range of interviews with internal and external stakeholders, a very, very rich tapestry of information that can be tapped into.
Now, our growing culture of transparency has culminated in the decision to make all of these studies publicly available in full. This has only become possible after a long process of recontacting the original interviewees, seeking their permission.
All of this information is going to be consolidated in a very user-friendly way on speakingout.msf.org, and it's going to be a site where you can very easily access information, download information, find links to a rich range of different materials that were used to reinforce the case studies as they were documented.
The Speaking Out Case Studies website will be online from October 2013, with the latest case study, which reflects on Médecins Sans Frontières' experience in Somalia from 1991 to 1993. The previously published case studies will be added regularly until 10 are available on the site, which will be linked to all the public websites of MSF around the globe. By releasing the record of its dilemmas publicly, the project aims to increase MSF's accountability and share the knowledge and experience of Médecins Sans Frontières' speaking out history for the benefit of anyone interested in learning more about humanitarian action.